As a way of drawing attention to the continued segregation in public facilities, the Congress of Racial Equality, CORE, launched the Freedom Rides on May 4, 1961.
This Freedom Ride was modeled after an earlier demonstration staged in 1947 in which an integrated group planned to take public buses from Washington, D.C. to New Orleans with the intent of integrating public facilities throughout the South.
In the 1961 Freedom Rides, an integrated group of civil rights activists rode Greyhounds and Trailway buses into the South, planning for black riders to enter white-only sections, while white riders would enter the colored white groups.
The integrating actions of these Freedom Riders met with a relatively minor resistance until they arrived in Anniston, Alabama on the 14th of May, 1961.
In Anniston, Alabama, a white mob awaited the arrival of the first bus bearing the Freedom Riders at the Greyhound station. As it arrived, they attacked the bus with iron pipes and baseball bats and slashed the tires.
The terrified bus driver hastily drove out of the station, but the punctured tires forced the bus to pull off the road in a rural area outside of Anniston, where the white mob who pursued the bus firebombed it and held the door shut, preventing the riders from exiting the burning car. Finally, an undercover policeman drew his gun and forced the doors to be opened. The mob pulled the Freedom Riders off the bus and beat them with the iron pipes.
The second bus carrying Freedom Riders arrived in Anniston an hour later at the Trailway station. The bus driver got off and talked with Anniston police and a group of eight white men. After the black Freedom Riders refused order to move to the back of the bus, the white gang came flying onto the bus and beat and stomped the rider.
In Birmingham, an FBI informant in the Ku Klux Klan learned of a detailed plan in which Police Chief Bull Connor had agreed to give the Klan 15 minutes after the bus arrived to beat the riders before local police would arrive. The plan was reported to the FBI headquarters, but no action was taken.
The Trailway station was filled with Klansmen and reporters. When the Freedom Riders exited the bus, they were beaten by a mob with baseball bats, iron pipes, and bicycle chains. And then, battered and bleeding, they were arrested.
When reports of the burning bus and beatings reached Attorney General Robert Kennedy, he urged restraint on the part of the Freedom Riders and sent an assistant, John S., to Montgomery, Alabama, to observe the Freedom Riders' arrival in that city, which was scheduled to happen shortly.
The remainder of the Freedom Riders were injured and battered, and CORE felt that they could not continue the Freedom Ride and elected to fly them to New Orleans, where they are disbanded.
At this point, SNCC felt more than ever that the Freedom Ride should continue. Again, Diane Nash of SNCC played a major role in salvaging the Freedom Rides when she sent out call to campuses around the eastern United States for volunteers to come join the Freedom Ride and to keep the demonstration going.